Hello everyone, I'm Priyanka Shain. Welcome to my YouTube channel Mathalite. In this video, we'll continue with exercise 14E from chapter Equation of a Line. So starting with question number 23. The given figure not drawn to scale shows two straight lines AB and CD. If equation of the line AB is y equals to x plus 1 and equation of line CD is y equals to root 3x minus 1, write down the inclination of lines AB and CD. Also find the angle theta between AB and CD. It's a very easy question. The figure is given to you and first thing that you have to do is find the inclination of line AB and CD. Inclination means angle find out karna hai. Okay, what angle they are making with positive x axis. So positive x axis right side pe hota hai. So x axis se AB ki taraf jo angle form ho raha hai. AB is this line. So its angle with positive x axis, that is this angle. Let's say it is theta 1. So ye theta 1 find out karna hai. Same way for CD, the inclination with positive x axis. So let this be theta 2. Theta 1, theta 2 find out karna hai first. Then we need to find theta, that is the angle between AB and CD. We'll come to that part later. First, let's see how we'll find theta 1 and theta 2. Inclination is related to slope. Okay, theta is related to slope of the line. So we know the formula m is equal to tan theta. So theta find out karne ke liye I need to find m. Slope find out karna padega. AB ka bhi slope find out karna padega. CD ka bhi slope find out karna padega. Slope we can easily obtain from the equation of the lines. Easily mil jayega. You just have to bring the equation in the standard form. ओके एंड यहाँ पे तो ऑलरेडी इक्वेशन स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्म में है. ए बी का इक्वेशन इज वाई इक्वल्स टू एक्स प्लस 1 एंड सी डी का इक्वेशन इज वाई इक्वल्स टू रूट 3x माइनस 1. ऑलरेडी स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्म में है. व्हाट इज द स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्म ऑफ इक्वेशन ऑफ अ लाइन? दिस कंपेयर करो एंड यू विल इजीली गेट m का वैल्यू. Let's say AB ka slope is M1 and CD ka slope is M2. Okay? Iske liye M1 lete hai, iske liye M2 lete hai. So, comparing, what will be the value of M1? 1 ho jayega. X ka koi coefficient nahi hai yahan pe, so it is 1. Hai na? So, M1 is 1 and what is M2? M2 is root 3. Okay? So, we have the values of the slopes. Okay? We need to find inclination. Ab theta find out karna hai. So using this formula. So I'll consider the first one M1. So M1 will be tan theta 1. M1 is 1. So 1 is equal to tan theta 1. That is I can say tan theta 1 is 1. Tan of which angle is 1? Kaun se angle pe 1 milta hai? You are supposed to know the standard values. Okay. So standard values का trigonometric table please learn students. You need this for such kind of sums. So tan 45 is 1. Tan 45 1 होगा. So एक ही angle का value ऐसा मिल सकता है. Okay, multiple values का नहीं हो सकता है. So therefore we can say theta 1 is 45 degrees. So we'll write down tan theta 1 is equal to tan 45. बिकॉज RHS सेम है तो LHS भी सेम होगा, इक्वल होगा. ओके, डोंट कैंसल आउट tan tan, दैट इज रॉन्ग. ओके, यू कैन नॉट कैंसल दैट आउट. सो दिस कंक्लूड्स दैट theta 1 इज इक्वल टू 45. डायरेक्टली लिख दो प्लीज, ये कैंसिल मत करना. ओके, दैट इज टोटली रॉन्ग. तो theta 1 मिल गया. ए बी का इंक्लिनेशन यू विल गेट एज 45 डिग्रीज. सेम वे M2 फाइंड आउट करेंगे, सेम मेथड. M2 is tan theta 2. M2 क्या मिल रहा है? Root 3. So tan of which angle is root 3? 60 degrees. Okay. So tan 0, 30, 45, 60, 90. You are supposed to know. Okay. So we are getting theta as, I'll directly write down, theta 2 is 60 degrees. Okay. So theta 2 मिल गया, theta 1 मिल गया. ओके, we'll easily get this. Now we need to find angle theta between AB and CD. AB and CD are intersecting at this angle. Okay, तो ये angle क्या होगा ये find out करना है. Now observe carefully. Observe only this part. ये एक triangle form हो रहा है यहाँ पे. Okay, ये triangle है. So I'll draw this triangular part. Okay, ये triangular part है और theta 2 ये बाहर में है. So this triangle, I've not drawn it properly. ऐसे है, okay? This is theta 1, that is, theta 1 is 45 degrees. This is theta 2, ये theta 1 है, then theta 2 यहाँ पे है, okay? So ये triangle के बाहर वाला exterior angle है ये, okay? So exterior angle is 60 degrees, theta 2 60 मिला था. And this is the angle between AB and CD, theta. ये theta, हम लोग यही angle से find out करेंगे, okay? Now, this is the exterior angle of the triangle and what is the property of exterior angle of a triangle? It is equal to the sum of the remote interior angles. That is, उसके बाजू वाला angle छोड़ दो, वो बाजू वाला angle छोड़ के जो बाकी दो angles है ना, उसका sum. So, 45 plus 30, sorry, plus theta is equal to 60. Okay? So, 45 plus theta is equal to 60. Theta, you'll get as 60 minus 45, that is 15 degrees. Okay. So, theta aise mil sakta hai. Another way is, 60 and this neighboring angle, they both are making linear pair. Okay. Ye dekho dhyan se. This is 60 and this neighboring angle is going to be 180 minus 60. Okay. So, it is a linear pair. So, by linear pair, I can easily find this angle. 120 ho jayega. 180 minus 60 is 120. So, this will be 120 degrees. Once I get this angle, I know two angles of a triangle, I can easily find the third angle. SOMAT property. Sum of measures of all angles of triangles is 180 degrees. So, theta plus 45 plus 120 is equal to 180. Equate karo, solve karo, and you will get theta ka value. Same way. सेम ही आंसर मिलने वाला है कोई भी मेथड फॉलो करो. ओके, सो आई विल बी यूजिंग एक्सटीरियर एंगल प्रॉपर्टी, दैट इज इजियर एंड स्मॉलर मेथड. सो आई विल बी यूजिंग दैट. यू कैन यूज द अदर मेथड ऑल्सो. पहले लीनियर पहले लो एंड देन सम ऑफ ऑल एंगल्स ऑफ ट्रायंगल्स. ओके, सो लेट अस सॉल्व नाउ प्रॉपरली. वील राइट डाउन अ कपल ऑफ स्टेटमेंट्स बिफोर स्टार्टिंग विद द सोल्यूशन. सो लेट द स्लोप्स ऑफ ए बी एंड सी डी बी एम वन एंड एम टू रिस्पेक्टिवली. And let the inclination of AB and CD be theta 1 and theta 2 respectively. Write the whole word, okay? No short forms. So, first we'll consider AB. AB ka equation kya hai? It is y equals to x plus 1. So, comparing what will be the slope of the line AB, it will be 1, okay? So, M1 is 1. Therefore, we can say tan theta is also 1 because tan theta 1 is equal to M1. Alright, so tan theta 1 is 1. Tan of which angle is 1? Tan 45 is 1. Therefore, tan theta 1 is tan 45. Therefore, theta 1 is 45 degrees. Okay. So, same way we'll find theta 2. That is inclination of the line CD. For CD, write down the equation. Y equals to root 3x minus 1. So, comparing with the standard form, what is the value of the slope? It is root 3. Jo bhi x ka coefficient hoga, wohi slope hoga. So, write down M2 is equal to root 3. So, we know the slope is related to the angle. So, tan theta 2 is equal to M2. That is, tan theta 2 is equal to root 3. Okay. Now, tan of which angle is root 3? It is 60 degrees. So, write down but tan 60 is equals to root 3. So therefore we can say RHS RHS same hai, toh LHS LHS bhi same hoga. That is tan theta 2 is equal to tan 60. Don't cancel tan tan. Theta 2 is equal to 60 degrees. Okay, box kar do. So we found the inclination of AB and CD. Ye 45 hai, ye 60 hai. Ab ye triangle part consider karo, ye exterior angle ho jayega 60 wala. Okay. So, before that, just write down inclination of line AB is 45 degrees and same way inclination of line CD is 60 degrees. These statements mat bhulna and also theta 1 and theta 2 jo bhi mil raha hai box kar do, okay? Now we'll find theta. I'll be using exterior angle property. You can also use the other method that I've shown. So theta plus 45 degrees is equal to 60 degrees. Write down exterior angle of a triangle. I'm not writing the full word. You have to write down full word. So theta is equal to 60 minus 45, so theta is equal to 15 degrees. Box kar do and write down the statement, the angle theta between AB and CD is 15 degrees. Please don't forget the final statement. Let's solve the next question, question number 24. Write down the equation of the line whose gradient is 3 by 2 and which passes through P, where P divides the line segment joining A minus 2 comma 6 and B 3 comma minus 4 in the ratio 2 is to 3. We have to find the equation of a line whose gradient is 3 by 2, that is slope is 3 by 2, okay? So gradient is other word for slope. So slope diya hai line ka, it is 3 by 2. And which passes through P, where P divides the line segment joining A and B in the ratio 2 is to 3. So there is a line which is passing through some point P. Okay. It is passing through some point P. And P is dividing a line segment joining A and B. So there is a segment joining two points A and B. A hai minus 2 comma 6, B hai 3 comma minus 4. We have to find the equation of this line, which is passing through P. For that, we are given the slope of the line. Iska slope pata hai. It is 3 by 2. We need one point ka coordinates because we'll need slope, we'll need one point ka coordinates to frame the equation. It is y minus y1 equals to m into x minus x1. M pata hai, x1, y1 find out karna hai, ek point ka coordinates. It is passing through point P, so P ka hi coordinates find out karte hai. Okay, now P is dividing the line segment in the ratio 2 is to 3. So you can apply section formula over here to find the coordinates of P. Hai na? So by section formula, what will be the coordinates of P? Take A as x1, y1, B as x2, y2. Okay, this is M, this is N. You are supposed to know section formula and midpoint formula. You should be thorough with the chapter. So P ka coordinates kya ho jayega? X coordinate will be mx2 plus nx1 upon m plus n. Same way for y coordinate, my2 plus ny1 upon m plus n. Put the values, okay? M ka value put karo, x2, x1. We know all the values, sab kuch pata hai, okay? So you can put the values and find out the coordinates of P. Once you get the coordinates of P, take P ka coordinates as capital X1, capital Y1. I'll be doing that because I've already used small x1, y1 over here, okay? So over here for the equation, capital Y1, capital X1, put the values of the coordinates of P. Put the value of slope, you will get the equation of this line passing through point P. Okay, so let us solve now. Draw the figure first and then start with the solution. P divides AB in the ratio 2 is to 3. This is already given to us. Therefore, M is to N is 2 is to 3. A we are taking as X1, Y1 and B as X2, Y2. P, capital X1, capital Y1. Okay, first we'll find the coordinates of P. So using section formula. Write down using section formula. P ka coordinates will be mx2 plus nx1 upon m plus n and my2 plus n y1 upon m plus n. Putting the values now. m 2 hai, x 2 is 3 plus n is 3, x 1 is minus 2 upon 2 plus 3. Over here, 2 into y 2 is minus 4 plus n is 3 into y 1 is 6 upon 2 plus 3. Write this, okay? 2 3s are 6 minus plus into minus minus ho jayega, right? 3 2s are 6 upon 2 plus 3, 5. Over here, minus 2 4s are 8 and your 3 6s are 18 upon 2 plus 3, 5. So, P x 1 y 1 will be 6 minus 6 is 0 upon 5 and 18 minus 8 will give 10 upon 5. So px1 y1 0 upon 5 will be 0, 10 upon 5 will be 2. So p ka coordinates mil gaya 0 comma 2 hai, okay? So box this, okay? Now we'll use the coordinates to find the equation of the line passing through P. For line passing through point P, P is x1, y1, which we just got, it is 0, 2. And slope is given to us, it is 3 upon 2, okay? So write this down, this is the information. Now we'll frame the equation. The equation of the line is y minus y1 equals to m into x minus x1. Y minus y1 hai 2, m is 3 by 2, so put brackets because 2 yahan pe shift hoga. X minus x1 is 0. 2 into y minus 2 equals to 3 into x minus 0. Your 2y minus 2 2s are 4 and 3x minus 0. X minus 0 is x, so 3 into x, 3x. Okay. So shifting 4 over here, 2y equals to 3x plus 4. So there are many ways of representing the equation. I'm going to represent it this way. Other way is y or 4 dono ko yahan pe shift kar do to ho jayega 3x minus 2y plus 4 equal to 0. Okay, that will be linear equation wala form. Okay, in linear equation actually number is on the other side. Other way of representing is shifting 2 over here, to standard form ho jayega y equals to 3 by 2 into x plus 4 by 2, that will give 2. So standard form mein it will be 3 by 2x plus 2. Okay, so up to you, you can consider any one form and box the equation. Don't forget the final statement. The equation of the line is 2y equals to 3x plus 4. Next question, question number 25. The ordinate of a point lying on the line joining the points 6, 4 and 7, minus 5 is minus 23. Find the coordinates of that point. Ordinate of a point means y coordinate. Okay, so whenever they say ordinate, wo y coordinate ho jayega. Okay, so koi bhi point ka ek x coordinate hota hai, ek y coordinate hota hai. This is abscissa. I might be wrong in spelling. Abscissa hoga ye, aur ye hoga ordinate. Okay. So this is called abscissa, x coordinate is called abscissa and y coordinate is called ordinate. So ordinate of a point lying on the line joining the points so and so is minus 23. So this is minus 23. Y coordinate bataya hai point ka, it is minus 23. We have to find the coordinates of that point, that is x coordinate bhi find out karna hai. Okay. Now we'll come to the details of the question. The ordinate of a point lying on the line joining the points 6, 4 and 7, minus 5. There is a line joining the points 6, 4 and 7, minus 5. 6, 4, 7, -5. So let this be A, let this be B. Okay. So line A B पे ये point lie कर रहा है. Now where it is lying, we don't know. It can lie anywhere. यहाँ पे हो सकता है, यहाँ पे हो सकता है. Okay. Somewhere. So let's name this point as P. P का y coordinate दिया है, ordinate दिया है. It is -23. What is the x coordinate? You have to find out. Okay. So since this point is lying on the line AB, it has to satisfy the equation of AB. वही logic यहाँ पे apply कर सकते हैं, because it is not dividing AB in some ratio. It is not the midpoint. Nothing else is given. So यहाँ पे we need the equation of the line AB. Okay. So if we know the equation of the line AB, we can put x as it is only, but y की जगह पे -23 डाल के हम लोग x का value find out कर सकते हैं. Let's say the equation of the line AB is 3x - 5y = 9, ऐसा कुछ है. तो x as it is रहेगा, y की जगह पे I can put -23 and find out x का value. Okay, because it has to satisfy the equation. Since it is lying on the line, it has to satisfy the equation. So A B का equation find out करना है. For that we have A का coordinates, B का coordinates. So we can find out the slope of the line. We'll need slope of the line and one point का coordinates. Okay. So let this be x1 y1, this be x2 y2. Slope मिल जाएगा y2 - y1 upon x2 - x1. Find करो AB का slope. Okay. So we'll easily get slope. Then consider x1 y1 and slope and find out the equation y - y1 = m(x - x1). So you'll get the equation of AB. Okay. Once you get the equation of AB, ऐसे कुछ form में मिलेगा, ये जैसा equation है वैसे form में मिलेगा. Then put the value of the y coordinate of P and find out the x coordinate. Okay. So let us solve now. Draw the figure for your reference. It will be easy for you to understand. And don't forget to write down the respective coordinates. Okay. Now first we need to find out equation of AB. Once we get the equation, then we can put the y coordinate of P and find out the x coordinate. Since it is lying on the line, it has to satisfy the equation. Okay. So पहले AB का equation find out करते हैं. So let A B 6, 4, that is x1 y1, B 7, -5, that is x2 y2. You have to name the points because they are not named over here. Okay. So पहले slope find out करेंगे for the equation. So write down m is equal to y2 - y1 upon x2 - x1 or y1 - y2 upon x1 - x2. So y2 is -5 - y1 = 4, x2 = 7 - x1 = 6. -5 - 4 दोनों नेगेटिव है, सो साइन विल बी नेगेटिव. एंड राइट डाउन द आंसर, एड इट. 7 - 6 = 1, सो -9 हो जाएगा आंसर. ओके, दैट इज स्लोप इज -9. नाउ ए वी हैव टेकन एज x1 y1, एम वी हैव, लेट अस फ्रेम द इक्वेशन. सो फॉर लाइन ए बी वी हैव ए x1 y1, दैट इज 6, 4, and m is -9. So the equation of line AB is y - y1 = m(x - x1). Put the values. y - y1 = 4 = -9 × x - 6. So y - 4 = -9x. -×+ हो जाएगा, 9, 6 = 54. Shifting 9x over here because negative है, so I'm going to shift 9x, group it with y and 4 को यहाँ पे shift करते हैं. 54 + 4 हो जाएगा, that is 58. 9x + y = 58 is the equation of the line AB. Okay, so you don't need to box this, final answer पे box कर देंगे. The equation of line AB is 9x plus y equals to 58. Now, since px, minus 23 is lying on this line, it has to satisfy the equation of the line. So, y coordinate substitute karenge and x coordinate find out karenge. First, write down let p be x, minus 23. Okay? P lies on line AB. Therefore, it satisfies the equation that is 9x plus y equals to 58. So, putting y equals to minus 23 in the equation, we'll get 9x plus y is minus 23 equals to 58. Plus minus, minus ho jayega. So 9x minus 23 is equal to 58. Shift 23, it'll be 58 plus 23. So 9x is equal to 58 plus 23 ho jayega 81. So x is 81 upon 9. 9 9s are 81. So x is 9. Okay. So we found the x coordinate of the point P. Okay. So now we have the coordinates of the point. So write down therefore P is 9 comma minus 23. Ye box kar do. Write down the final statement. The coordinates of the point P are 9 comma minus 23. Don't forget the final statement. Okay. Let's read the next question. Question number 26. Points A and B have coordinates 7 comma minus 3 and 1 comma 9 respectively. Find first part the slope of AB, second part the equation of perpendicular bisector of the line segment AB, third part the value of P if minus 2 comma P lies on it. There are two points A and B and we are given the coordinates. Pehle A hai, so pehle A ka coordinates and then B, so B ka coordinates. So A 7 comma minus 3 and B 1 comma 9. So join A and B. We have to find first the slope of AB. So for slope, first you will subtract y coordinates and then in denominator x coordinates. So 9 minus minus 3 upon 1 minus 7. You can go the other way around also. Minus 3 minus 9 upon 7 minus 1. Okay, you will still get correct answer. So AB ka slope mil jayega. Second, the equation of perpendicular bisector of the line segment AB. So there is a perpendicular bisector of AB. Perpendicular bhi hai aur bisect bhi kar raha hai. So there is a line which is perpendicular as well as bisecting. Okay. Let it meet AB at point P. So we have to find the equation of this line. Okay. For the equation of a line, we need two things. First thing is slope of the line. Okay. So ye perpendicular line ka slope kaise find out karenge? We can find only coordinates of P. Okay. P is lying on both the lines because it is point of intersection of two lines. So P ka coordinates mujhe mil jayega, which is lying on this line. I need one more point ka coordinates which I don't have. So what I'll do? This line is perpendicular to AB. So for perpendicular lines, product of the slopes is equal to minus 1. So the slope of this perpendicular line into slope of AB is equal to minus 1. Okay. So slope of line perpendicular to AB into slope of AB is minus 1. So I need to find slope of AB. तो ही मुझे perpendicular line का slope मिलेगा. AB का slope तो मुझे already first part में मिल रहा है. I am finding it. Okay. So slope of AB का value put करो. You will get the slope of the line perpendicular to AB. तो इसका slope मिल जाएगा. That is M मिल जाएगा. Okay. Once you get M, you need one point का coordinates. तो P is lying on this line. So P का coordinates find out करना पड़ेगा. Since P is midpoint of AB, because this line is perpendicular as well as bisector. So it is passing through the midpoint of AB. Okay. So P is the midpoint of AB. By midpoint formula, I can find the coordinates of P. So P ka coordinates kya ho jayega? For x coordinate, add the x coordinates of A and B, divide by 2. So 7 plus 1 divide by 2. For y coordinate, add the y coordinates and divide by 2. So minus 3 plus 9 divide by 2. Okay, so you'll easily get the coordinates of P. Once you get the coordinates of P and you have the slope of the line, you can easily frame the equation. You will have x1, y1. You will have m. So equation of the line is y minus y1 equals to m into x minus x1. Put the values of x1, y1, put the value of m. You'll get the equation of the line perpendicular to AB. Okay, that is perpendicular bisector of AB. Okay, so let us solve now. First, write down the coordinates. A is 7, minus 3 and B is 1, 9. We'll find slope of AB. Slope of AB will be, subtracting the y coordinates first, 9 minus minus 3 upon 1 minus 7. So that will give minus minus plus. So 9 plus 3 upon 1 minus 7 is minus 6. That is 12 upon minus 6. 6 2s are, and minus will go in numerator. So minus 2. Slope of AB mil gaya. Okay. Now we need to find in second part the equation of the perpendicular bisector of the segment AB. So for that we have to write a few statements. So let's write down the statements first. Write down, let the perpendicular bisector of AB meet AB at P. Therefore, P is the midpoint of AB. So by midpoint formula, P ka coordinates kya ho jayega? For x coordinate, add the x coordinates of A and B, divide by 2. So 7 plus 1 divided by 2. And for y coordinates, add the y coordinates and divide by 2. Okay. So P ho jayega 8 upon 2 comma 9 minus 3 is 6 upon 2. So P will be 4 comma 3. Okay. So we got the coordinates of point P. Now we need the slope of the line which is perpendicular bisector of AB, kyunki uska equation find out karna hai. Since it is perpendicular to AB, therefore product of the slopes is equal to minus 1. So write down, for the line perpendicular to AB, slope will be negative reciprocal of the slope of AB. Hai na? Because slope of the line into slope of AB, agar yahan pe shift kar do, slope of the line into slope of AB is equal to minus 1. So it is negative reciprocal of slope of AB. So minus 1 upon slope of AB, we just got it is minus 2. So minus minus plus ho jayega, 1 upon 2. So slope of the perpendicular bisector of AB is 1 upon 2. M is 1 upon 2. We have one point ka coordinates. M hai, x1, y1 hai. Let us frame the equation of the perpendicular bisector. So for the perpendicular bisector of AB, we have the slope. We just found it. It is half. And P is lying on the perpendicular bisector. So P, that is 4, 3, we'll take as x1, y1. So the equation of the line is y minus y1 equals to m into x minus x1. Y minus y1 hai 3, m is half, put brackets because 2 yahan pe shift hoga. X minus x1 is 4. So 2 into y minus 3 is equal to 1 into x minus 4. 1 into anything will give that thing itself. So yahan pe ho jayega 2y minus 6 equals to x minus 4. Shift 6 over here to positive ho jayega. Okay. So it will become minus 4 plus 6. Okay. So 6 minus 4 gives टू, सो एक्स प्लस टू हो जाएगा. सो टू वाई इज इक्वल टू एक्स प्लस टू इज द इक्वेशन ऑफ द लाइन. सो इक्वेशन ऑफ द परपेंडिकुलर बाइसेक्टर इज टू वाई इक्वल्स टू एक्स प्लस टू. ऑलराइट, सेकेंड पार्ट मिल गया. द इक्वेशन ऑफ द परपेंडिकुलर बाइसेक्टर ऑफ द लाइन सेगमेंट ए बी इज टू वाई इक्वल्स टू एक्स प्लस टू. डोंट फर्गेट टू राइट द स्टेटमेंट. ओके, आई एम नॉट राइटिंग डाउन द स्टेटमेंट. एंड ये इक्वेशन को बॉक्स कर दो. ऑल राइट, नाउ वील कम टू द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चन. वी हैव टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ पी इफ माइनस टू कॉमा पी लाइज ऑन इट. लाइज ऑन वॉट? लाइज ऑन द परपेंडिकुलर बाइसेक्टर. ओके, यहाँ पे नहीं लिखा है किस पे लाई कर रहा है. सो इट मीन्स इट इज लाइंग ऑन परपेंडिकुलर बाइसेक्टर बिकॉज प्रीवियस पार्ट में वी जस्ट फाउंड द इक्वेशन ऑफ परपेंडिकुलर बाइसेक्टर. ओके, सो इट इज लाइंग ऑन परपेंडिकुलर बाइसेक्टर, नॉट ऑन ए बी. सो सिंस इट इज लाइंग ऑन द परपेंडिकुलर बाइसेक्टर, इट हैज टू सेटिस्फाई द इक्वेशन. ओके, सो एक्स की जगह पे माइनस टू पुट करो, वाई की जगह पे पी पुट करो एंड फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ पी. सो राइट डाउन माइनस टू कॉमा पी लाइज ऑन द लाइन 2y equals to x plus 2, that is on the perpendicular bisector. Therefore, it satisfies the equation. Okay, so putting x equal to minus 2 and y equals to p, equation kya ho jayega? 2y equals to x plus 2 hai, so 2 into p equals to minus 2 plus 2, right? X की जगह पे minus 2 put किया. So 2p equals to 2 minus 2 is 0. So p is equal to 0 upon 2, that is nothing but 0. So p का value मिल गया, it is 0. Box कर दो. Write down the statement, the value of p is 0. All right?